Hello and welcome to Red Live. Compliments to the new year. Hopefully all my subscribers are still alive and kicking. And one of your new year's resolutions should be to watch a little bit more of Red Live. Now onto the video. Mziyafani Mzondeleli Boltina. With a name like that, he was probably teased in school. He's better known by Ifani. Now, Ifani is a South African hip-hop rap artist, is an MC and a television presenter. Now, you guys might know him from his first single that actually blew up. It was Hola Hater. And then it was also he followed that up by Airway. I remember Airway. Airway was a very big song. And then Shake. Now Shake, I would say, was one of those songs that kind of put him on the map, because I remember the video, I went crazy. I love this song. Shake was actually the song that kind of made me fall in love with South African hip-hop yet again. I'd say he's actually the first South African hip-hop artist to actually attain gold status for an album on the day of its release. Talking about albums, he has released two albums. It's I Believes in Me First Quadrant that was released in 2013. I Believes in Me Second Quadrant that was released in 2015 April. Now, as I said, he had an album reach gold status, and that is his second quadrant. It reached gold status, meaning it sold over 20,000 copies as per the Recording Industry of South Africa, RISA, albums configurations. Ifani was born in the Eastern Cape province. He studied at the University of Cape Town. He did a BSc, the Computer Science and Computer Engineering course. Following his graduation, Ifani worked as a process control engineer. So he was definitely a bookworm and he's a very intelligent man. Now, during his time working, he was involved in some hip hop battles, some ciphers, you know, some underground rap work, and that's where his love of hip hop kind of came to fruition. In terms of awards, Ifani was the best freshman at the 2012 South African Hip Hop Awards. At the 20th annual South African Music Awards this summer, Ifani's album I Believes in Me First Quadrant won the Best Rap Album of the Year award. He was also awarded the Best Hip Hop Artist at the Eastern Cape Music Awards in 2015. Now, he's also been on television. He was a presenter on the SABC 1 reality series Tambo Stomp, Amabantula. He also hosted reality series Clash of the Choirs. He was one of the three celebrities on the ETV Reality Check series. He has hosted Mi Casa, Su Casa. He has also appeared on Late Night News with Loiso Kola, Jam Sandwich, Idol Season 10, I Love South Africa Season 1, The Man Cave Season 3, Top Billing, and Zaziwa. So what happened to Ifani? Let us begin at 2012, when Ifani was at his most popular and at his high. He signed with Sony record label, released his album I Believes in Me, which was a huge hit and a huge success. Now, just before his second album, two years later in 2014, he was on social media venting his unhappiness with his record label Sony. Now, these are some of the tweets that I could find. Leaving my label is the only solution, but since they know that it will make me happy, they will fight it. It's as if they hate my smile. He also went as far as saying that he wishes that he wasn't as successful. When your record label breaks your spirit, when they shut you down so many times you lose the will to fight, I asked myself, why did I sign? Of course I can't write my record label's name, because they will do more harm to me than they already have. I wish I could just give the success back. Now, obviously, we don't know what happened behind the scenes and behind the closed doors that brought him to vent his feelings on social media in such a way. Nor do we know exactly what the record label was doing to actually cause him so much dissatisfaction. But this tweet might just give us a little bit of insight. So I finally tweeted, all I can do right now is pray and hope for the best. My fingers are also crossed. I need to leave my record label ASAP before my creativity dies. Now, this tweet will lead us to believe that perhaps, you know, the record label was actually telling him to do some stuff, tone his down, change his style, and he felt like he was losing his own creativity in the process. In 2015, he released his second album, like I said, I Believes in Me, Second Quadrant. Around 2016, it seemed like Ifani and Sony had kind of mended their differences, and he released a statement around June 2016. Now, the statement reads as follows. I remember how happy I was when I got signed. I remember how sad I was after I blew up. I was a lost child. Godwa, I am glad I changed. I was mad trying to get them to change so I could be happy. Little did I know that it's me who had to change before my world could change. I've learned that blame only destroys the person blaming, not the blamed. Until the person decides to change and embrace life, Forgiving yourself is the first step towards happiness. Then forgive others. Then learn that nobody can make you happy except you. I've learned a lot in the past year, a lot about myself, about success, about happiness. I apologize for the person I was, sincerely. Now, I also announced during that time that his third album was coming out sometime in February 2017. Now, as far as I can tell, there is no third album out as of yet. Now, I did release a couple of singles that were said to be from or for the actual third album. Then we had the AKA drama on iFinance album Going Gold. Now, AKA threw a lot of subtle shade at iFinance album reaching gold status. AKA wrote this on social media. For the record, I think iFinance deserves that gold status for working the system. He saw an opportunity and took it. More power to him. He continued to write, "Don't get me wrong, guys. I applaud iFinance for getting Reds to take his album to gold status. We could learn a lot from that move." Now, me reading those messages, I get the impression that AKA was kind of insinuating that Reds actually bought the 20,000 copies of the album to help it reach gold status. Now, AKA also went on to tweet, now this is more talking about himself when he gets his gold status. He wrote that, "When we finally get that gold plaque, it's going to feel good knowing that every single sale was made by a fan who felt the need to buy it." So like I said, some very subtle shade, you blink, you will miss it. While we're on the subject of beef, let us talk about his beef with Casper Nyovest. Now, the timing of this beef was kind of horrible. Casper Nyovest had just lost his ponytail. And he had just released his first single, Tito Mboweni, from his upcoming album, Tuto. I finally took to social media and called the single trash. Now, I'm not gonna lie, I was one of those people who actually agreed with him, and I still do. But one thing I will say, like, the video kind of just made that song, it took the song to another level. And obviously, the single did well, the video did well. And at the end of the day, I finally went on to social media again to apologize. And then there was that one time when he saw at a Metro FM DJ. DJ Rashid K said that the rapper was no longer relevant or part of the local hip hop. In response, iFinance tweeted, "In the most respectful and loving manner, fuck you." You know what, that's straightforward and to the point, so moving right along. So in the meantime, like I said, a third album was actually announced. We are still waiting for it, and I have my fingers crossed. I can't wait for the third album. iFinance is definitely one of those hip-hop artists that has actually brought South African hip-hop to the forefront of music in South Africa. So, you know, it would be nice to have him release more music. I'd definitely be waiting eagerly to hear some of that. But like I said, he's also got his BSc degree to fall back on if this music thing does not work. Hopefully it does work out for him. So do comment down below if you guys would love to hear another iFinance album. By the way, if my voice sounds a little bit funny, I've got the New Year's flu, so that's why I've been quiet for a little while. But I think it's there, it's getting better, but everyone's always been complaining about my voice, so And as always, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to Red Live and binge watch my previous videos.